माय फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू आज गीतेज एस्ट्रोलॉजी। कृष्ण इज हैप्पीनेस, कृष्ण ही खुशी हैं एज ऑलवेज से। एंड फ्रेंड्स, वी टुडे टॉक अबाउट अ न्यू टॉपिक रिगार्डिंग पंचांगा ओनली। इट इज द हिंदू डे ऑन विच वी आर बॉर्न, दैट इज शुक्ल प्रतिपदा और शुक्ल द्वितीय, लाइक दिस। सो वी हैव 30 डेज इन टोटल and it is divided into two paths, one is Shukla Paksh and the other one is Krishna Paksh. So today we'll start with Shukla Paksh first date, that is Pratham Tithi Pratipada. So Shukla Pratipada, we'll talk about it, and I have made earlier videos for the days also when we are born, because it tells us lot about our life. From Monday to Wednesday I have made, please do go and watch those videos. And then I am making videos for the Hindu year also, that is called Samvatsar, in which Hindu year we are born. Yes, I'll soon be posting the video, so please see that also, and please subscribe the channel, keep liking it, and please do comment whatever you feel like asking me, or if there any query with you. So today we'll talk about Shukla Pratipada. So this day falls after the Amavasya Tithi, that is the day when there is no moon. So Shukla Pratipada is the first day after Amavasya. So this day is actually considered a little bit low. Low means like it is not that much auspicious. The other day, that Krishna Paksha Pratipada, is more auspicious, as it falls after the Purnima Tithi. So this day actually is not that much fruitful for the natives who are born on the first day of Shukla Pratipada after Amavasya. I'll tell you why it is this. The natives that are born on this day, actually they are very intelligent, they are very sharp, they have big family. They love their family also, their mother loves them very much, and they actually have that swiftness in them, they have that fire in them to do work and rise to the peak. They accumulate wealth also very easily and very fast. So what are the problem areas with them? The problem areas are like they get influenced by the bad company very much. It's more likely that they fall into bad company, so they have to restrict them from that. So early childhood, in the school days, or when you are in college, these are the days when you have to see that the person who are born on Shukla Pratipada Tithi, they don't go out of route, out of control, because that will bring a problem to them and to their families also. So in this case, it is not good. The other points are, it is not considered auspicious to do certain things on this day, like many religious ceremonies or marriages and all that kind of stuff. It is because this date actually is considered to do some hard work, and these people are hard working people also. So they should always concentrate on their hard work, discipline, and whatever problem if they are facing in their life, they should ask answers from God. If they are on the path of Dharma, they'll never fall into that trap of bad company, bad people, or they'll never get out of route. They'll never rise to that kind of anger also, because on this day, on the natives who are born on Shukla Pratipada, they are more likely to get into that kind of rage, like very much anger, and they lose temper very much. So they have to look for that. It's because of this only this tithi is considered bad actually. Otherwise it's very sharp, they are very intelligent, good looking, they have good families. The profession in which they can go is like, they can be good doctors, they can be good leaders, they can go into military, they can do work related to wood, any kind of carpentries or selling wooden items or something like that. Then they can go into medicines, they'll be good administrators, they'll do very good in government jobs, and they are the people actually who open things. So the opening ceremonies, event management they can do. So these people are actually very good at it. This Pratipada, Shukla Pratipada actually means the starting point, to start something. So they actually start everything very accurately, but it is the journey in which they do some faults that can lead them into trouble. So they have to be very disciplined in that. And the problems, if they have any problems in life, they can worship Lord Agni, and they should actually, they have to, because the deity of this Shukla Pratipada Tithi is Agni, Lord Agni. So they have to perform any kind of yagna or havan in their house in the month, and they should actually do havan with desi ghee so that it pleases Lord Agni, and it will give you all kind of sincerity, intelligence, happiness. Then they can worship Lord Sun also. They have to worship actually Lord Sun, because this tithi is related to Lord Sun. The Lord Sun is the ruler of this Shukla Pratipada tithi. So they have to, the person born on this tithi, they have to daily worship Lord Surya for all kind of gains in their life, for their health problems. And health wise, like in the childhood, they'll face some kind of problems, like death type movements also they can have. They can fall into any kind of trap, or they can go into any kind of severe diseases in their childhood life. So if they overcome that, mostly they are long lived people. They live up to 80 or 90 years. They are strong built, they are very good in their health afterwards. But that problematic area is the childhood period, and the period when you are in college. You have to see that you don't fall into any kind of bad companies, and then always control your temper, your rash decisions and all that kind of thing. And whatever thing you plan to do in your life, please do a thorough research about it and then start something. The best thing is, please take advice from your elders, or take advice from people who have done those work before, and so you can get all the kind of information you need, and then you proceed with your work. You will never fail. This is the biggest secret for the Shukla Pratipada people, because they mostly they falter in this only. They start something without thinking, without actually gaining knowledge, and then actually they fall, and they have to see this. And then they can worship goddess Shalputri. It's a form of god Durga. This is she governs the first day, that is the Shukla Pratipada. And today actually it's Shukla Pratipada, the first day of Sharadiya Navratra. Yes, you have to worship, you can worship mother goddess Shalputri. She will also give you all kind of happiness, wealth, joy, warmth you need in life. Your family will be happy, you will be happy. And the last one is, you should always worship Lord Ganesha. Well, whatever thing you do in life, please take his name, because he is actually he is the one actually in Hinduism who is who means the start. Whenever we start something, we take Lord Ganesha's name. He is associated with the starting point, and this tithi also is a starting point, Shukla Pratipada after Amavasya tithi. So whatever you do in your life, your studies, your work, anything, any important discussion, you always take his name first and then proceed with your work, any work, and you will get success. So these are the four points you have to remember. These are the remedies also. So actually this tithi is only difficult, it's only said difficult because of the temperament that these people have, like their rash decisions. They can go into bad companies, they can sometimes fall into some wrong things because of their deeds. So they have to just look for that. एंड इफ ऑन दिस डे when the native is born on Shukla Pratipada, if that day is a Tuesday or Sunday, then it's actually more trouble. So you have to be more cautious on this day or these points that I have told you. And if it is a Friday on a Shukla Pratipada when you were born, then you are lucky. It's a happy time for you. All the demerits, all the problematic areas are actually never going to come to you. It will all vanish by the grace of God. So you please consider all the points that I have told you. Otherwise, this is a very glorious day. It's a very nice day. It's a day when you have to be actually spiritually attached to God or Dharma. You have to be on the path of Dharma, because it is said that on this day Lord Shiva is in the actually graveyard, yeah, cremation ground. So he sits there, he meditates there. So it is that kind of date, Shukla Pratipada, when he is there in his deep meditation. So it means for you like all the answers you will get when you will sit in that pose of meditation pose, or when you are calm and quiet, and when you are looking for answers, you will get it from the God or the Dharma or the elders or your mother. Your mother is going to love you very much. You love her also very much. So please consider all these points, and I hope this will help you. And this is all for now. So I'll be back with the next date, next tithi, that is Shukla Ditvi, in the next video. Till then, Jai Shri Krishna.